Jesus.
Get off of my body. Get off of my
body.
Hallelujah.
Gloria.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Father, we give you praise now in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Yes, he's worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Get your Bibles and just want to turn.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Verses.
Yes.
Amen. We just read these things.
Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
The Lord is gracious.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. Amen. Verse 14, the Lord upholdeth all that fall, and raiseth up all those that be bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon them, and thou givest them their peace. This verse 15. The eyes of all wait upon thee, and thou givest them their meat in season. Thou openest thine hand and satisfiest the desire of every living thing. Yes. The Lord is nigh unto all that call upon him. To all that call upon him.
Yes.
He will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. He also will hear their cry and will save them. Amen. 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 We just thank God for his word. Amen. Praise God. And I just want to turn to a couple of scriptures. Psalms, this is Psalms 37. These are going to be some scriptures that we're going to put a lot of emphasis on this week. Psalms 35, 27. Psalms 35, 27, and Psalms 84, 11. Glory, hope, and Christian. Psalms 35, 27. This scripture said, let them shout for joy and be glad that favor my righteous cause. Yet let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Amen. We are putting a lot of emphasis on prosperity this week because I feel that this is where many of us are. And the scripture admonishes us to, amen, let's begin to shout the praises of God. In other words, we don't want to hold back. We want to let go. We want to release all that we have.
Yes, thank you.
It would be a wonderful thing for us to get out of us all of the praise of us. You can praise God until you can't praise him anymore.
Yes, thank you.
Praise him until you can't praise him anymore. So this scripture says, let them shout. That means that we have to exert some energy. We have to raise our voices. We have to go beyond the normal boundaries. Amen. And we have to give God all that we have. Amen. I think that if you give God all that you have, then God is going to give you, amen, all that you need. Amen. Let them shout for joy.
Yes, amen. Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. So how many believe that it's all right to lift your voices?
Amen. Yes, thank you.
Your breakthrough, amen, the breakthrough is in what? Opening our mouths.
Yes.
Amen. I didn't get nowhere trying to receive the Holy Ghost. Amen. With my mouth shut.
Amen.
They told me to cry loud. Amen. 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 Be loud. And cry out. The moment I lifted my voice and cried out, amen, that's when I had a breakthrough. Amen. Something broke. Whatever that barrier, that hindrance, amen, praise God. Whatever that had prevented me, that really was released. Amen.
Amen.
Let them shout for joy and be glad. Amen. How many know how to be glad?
Amen. Yes.
Gives us a definition that you have to kind of clarify. Sometimes people think any level of praise is being glad. But I think that you can get extremely glad. Amen. I think that you can, amen, be over, amen, over joyous. I mean, you can just really go to the limit and be glad. The scripture says that favor my righteous cause. Amen. How many favor God's righteous cause tonight?
Amen.
Amen.
How many is with God's word?
Amen.
You side with the word. Amen. God says
that's right.
What?
Amen.
Amen. Shout for joy and be glad. Amen. If you side with all of these things that God is, amen, is promising us, all of these scriptures and blessings and benefits that God is releasing into our lives, has made possible for us, scripture says we need to be extremely, amen, joyous and happy, appreciative of those things. Shout for joy and be glad that faith of my righteous cause. Yea, let them say continually. Yes. That's the key. You gotta what? Say continually. Amen. You gotta keep saying these things that magnify God. These things that releases your praise and releases the healing and releases the blessings. Amen. See, we overcome by the what? Blood. Amen. This is what Jesus has already done for us over 2,000 years ago.
Yes.
But we gotta what? We got to affirm it. We gotta say it. We gotta continue to what? Magnify God and really begin to call the things that be not as though they are. Let them say continually, let the Lord be what?
Magnified.
Amen. Come on, I want you to lift your voice right now. Just amen. And say, Lord be magnified.
Lord be magnified.
Let the Lord be magnified in me.
Lord be magnified in me.
Say it differently. It says shout for joy. Lord be what?
Magnified in me.
Yes. Hallelujah.
The Lord is magnified when we what? Worship Him. Praise Him. Exalt Him.
Yes.
Hey. Hey.
Yes.
Lord. Amen. What would happen if everybody said, Lord be magnified? Hey. Amen. Let me see how loud you can shout.
Lord be magnified in me.
All right. Amen. I believe we can do better than that.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Lord,
amen. We need to, amen, get out of this little comfort zone and become a radical church. I believe God, we can get radical from this, right?
Amen.
I believe Brother Curtis has got a pretty loud voice. Say, Lord be magnified, Brother Curtis.
Lord be magnified in me.
Yes. Amen.
You believe if you shout that, you believe he'll be magnified?
Amen.
You're great. I mean, something is going to happen on the inside of you when you what? Give God the glory that He is due. Amen. Praise God. Now, the last part it says, which hath what? Pleasure in the what? Prosperity of His servant.
Yes.
God has what? Pleasure in the prosperity. I want you to shout that. Lord, you have pleasure. Come on, say.
Lord, you have pleasure.
Lord,
you have pleasure. Prosperity of His servants.
Amen. Yes. Lord, you have what? Pleasure in the prosperity of His servants. In other words, we need to what? Tell God, amen, praise God, that He has pleasure in the prosperity. See, when you begin to say that, then God really began to what? He began to make that a reality. He has pleasure. Sometimes people don't think that God wants them to prosper. Amen. But we want to keep it in our hearts that God has what? Pleasure in the what?
Prosperity
of His servant. He wants me to prosper. He delights in my prosperity.
Yes.
So I'm going to delight in Him. If we delight in Him, He'll what? Give us the what? Desires of our heart.
Hallelujah.
Hey, we know He delights in prosperity, so we got to what? Delight in Him.
Yeah. Yes.
Hey, come on, put your hand.